Hi guys! The DJI Mavic 3 series received an intensive update with long-awaited features. What it is and what you can expect, I'm gonna show you in this video, so stay tuned! If you like what you see, then help the channel to grow and subscribe. Just a few days ago, the Mavic 3 series received the latest update with brand new features. These features are so innovative, we've never seen on any DJI drone before. Especially one feature will absolutely blow your mind. I never thought that this could be possible, but let's first talk about the smaller but no less important improvements. First of all, there is the new D-Log M and HLG video with the 7X tele camera. From now on, you are able to match scenes that you have taken with wide angle lens, with 3X tele zoom and with the 7X in terms of color and consistency. A lot of videographers were pretty frustrated with the former situation because each record had to be edited differently. So from now on, DJI have resolved this, and that's why this update is so important. So post-productions will be much more efficient and with less effort. Another welcome feature is the ability of the medium 3X tele camera to do Mastershots, Quickshots and capture the spherical panorama. Especially the first two are pretty cool as they are used more often from the beginners and are really easy to understand. From now on, the 3X tele camera can do it and you can enjoy working with the parallax effect during these shots. You know, this is the effect where the impression is created that the background is closer to the subject. While creating the tiny planet effect, the drone is shooting 106 images, which takes at least 5 minutes. I don't know why it needs 106, but at the end, all of them are put together to one big image with a nice effect. Well, I don't know that many people are using this feature. So that were quite nice and useful features on the tele camera. But now let's have a look to the maybe not most useful, but most interesting feature that comes up with the update. It is called Vision Assist and blow my mind as I wasn't aware that this was possible. This feature uses the obstacle avoidance sensors as cameras. Yes, you got it right. So each of the four obstacle avoidance sensors seem to be cameras, and with this update you can switch the view to each of this camera. They provide you not more than a black and white image on a pretty low quality, but it helps you getting a much better awareness on the surrounding of your drone when flying. This feature is available on the lower left corner of your DJI fly app, right next to the obstacle radar. Just swipe here to the left or even to the right and the view will switch to the sensor mode with the camera. By clicking on the enlarge icon, you will get the view on the whole screen. By using the little arrows on the top, bottom, left or right, you can switch to each of the sensor views. So in case you want to lock the view, all you have to do is to hold down the arrow just for a second. Next, all Mavic 3 drones receive the AR return to home route. By default, the feature is now activated in the fly app and can be seen when using the return to home button. It provides the pilot with the precise path the drone will take to come home. And speaking about home point, the drone now has a virtual home point indicator showing as a small H icon on the screen where the home point is located. In case the home point is not in sight, a small arrow on the edge of the screen is shown indicating the direction where the home point is. This function is amazingly helpful in terms of orientation. For example, when you have reset your home point or using waypoint function or something else, it always helps the pilot because now you can see it right there on the screen. Also pretty cool is the AR aircraft shadow that is shown on screen when landing your drone. So what's it gonna do? It's showing you the precise position when your drone is gonna touch the ground. So the next safety feature is called land protection switch. You can now disable that short pause your drone is gonna proceed right before landing. Why is that so interesting and part of the safety feature? Because this helps you when trying to land your drone on a moving subject like a boat. Before that implementation, it was pretty hard to get your drone back when the object you were on was moving. However, you should be quite careful with that function, because if you descend too fast while landing, it can heavily bump your drone to the ground, and which can cause damage. The last helpful feature that was added to this update is the so-called frame guide, which can be activated in the camera settings. Right before, no, this frame will not crop your image or videos, but should help you to get a better understanding in terms of your later editing when creating videos and movies in different formats than your drone is recording. The shadows are just for reference, so you can see what the final image or record will look like. All right, so that's it what you're gonna get when installing the latest firmware update for your Mavic 3 series. Hope this video was helpful for you. So if you liked the video, drop me a comment below, smash the like button and sub to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.